we proceed. Write down next. Guys, next we are going to study circuits with capacitor and inductor. When it is a DC supply, inductor is zero resistance path and capacitor is an open circuit. But with AC, they are different. Okay, so there is one easy way to analyze the alternating current circuit that uses a mathematical concept called phasors. So this is just a brief introduction. We are not going into too much of detail of phasor, like what it is and you know all that. We'll just talk about what all things are useful with respect to phasor, and that's it. Okay, so phasors are nothing but rotating vectors. Write down. They are rotating vectors. Fine. One thing is finding the average value and other is to get the exact value as a function of time. Okay. So now when you draw voltage on x y axis, you get a wave sort of thing. Fine. So you can't just draw waves and it becomes very easy to convey the meaning of the wave. So phasor is the easier way to convey what do we mean by Vm sin omega t or Im sin omega t plus phi and all that. Okay. So if there is a vector that starts from this axis, if it rotates with angular velocity omega, this angle will be what? Omega into t. Fine. This vector just keeps on rotating. Right, you'll see that after time t, if you take its projection on the y-axis, you will get the vector magnitude times sine of omega t. Fine. This vector could be voltage, could be current. Let's say this is voltage whose peak value is v0. So this vector is denoting the peak value. The length of the vector is the peak value of voltage or current. Getting it? So if this is voltage, this length will become how much? V0 sin omega t. Getting it? So it becomes easy to represent. We'll say that the rotating vector's projection on the y-axis is the voltage that is going on. Fine. Suppose current is I0 sin of omega t minus pi by 2. Then how will you represent here in the phasor? It will be 90 degree behind?
Yeah.
It will be like this, 90 degree behind this. Fine. So like that, you will have an idea. So this is current, right now current is behind the voltage by 90 degrees. Okay. So we are going to, that's it. Okay. We are not going into too much of detail of phasors. So we are going to use this particular knowledge to analyze the circuits further. Any doubt on phasors? Write down inductor in AC voltage. Inductor with alternating voltage. Okay. So if you have inductance is L, V is equal to V0 sin omega t, like this. You need to find same thing like VRMS, IRMS, average power, V is given I. These five things. This thing is already given. This is V0 sin omega t. You need to find other four. try to write Kirchhoff's equation. The potential difference across inductor is LdI by dt. Then you will have to integrate and all.
How about V by LdI is equal to
VT?
See, all of you got this V naught sin omega t minus LdI by dt is equal to 0. Got this? Then you will get LdI by dt. This di is V naught by L sin omega t dt. Okay, this is di, this is not I. Okay, so I will become what? V naught by omega L sin omega t plus a constant. We don't know the limits. Okay, but one thing is pretty clear. Average of voltage is 0, so average of current should also be 0. Fine? So when you take average of current, you will get what? This becomes 0, so this becomes constant. So that should be 0. Constant should be 0.
Sir,
how do you
know sin omega? Should it be
cos omega? And minus actually.
Yeah, minus cos omega. But that minus only should be directional current.
Okay? So first write down this. The average of current should be 0, so constant is
0.
Right? So I get current as minus V naught by omega L cos of omega t. Fine. This thing, if you compare with voltage, voltage is what? V naught sin omega t. If you write down in terms of sin, you get V naught by omega L sin of omega t minus pi by 2. Yes or no? So current is behind the voltage by pi by 2. Or voltage is ahead of current. So current you can write down here as, and one more thing I'll tell you. This is sin of omega t minus pi by 2. This thing, omega into L, is it behaving like resistance? Yeah. If omega L is large, current becomes small. So it behaves like a resistance, but we can't call it resistance. So some rhyming term we call it reactance. Fine. So reactants are two types, capacitor and for inductor. This is capacitive reactance, that is equal to omega L.
Inductive reactance.
Yeah, inductive reactance. Fine. And VRMS will be what? V naught by root 2. And IRMS will be what? This is again sin only. If you square it, it becomes V naught by root 2 times omega L. Isn't it? What about power? Average power is how much? How much?
V naught square by 2.
0.
Okay.
Power is what? Instantaneous power is V into I. V is V naught sin omega t. I is minus V naught by omega L cos omega t. You will get minus V naught square by 2 omega L sin 2 omega t. Sin omega t cos omega t divided by, that into 2 is sin 2 omega t. Okay? When you take average of this, it becomes 0 or not? Right? So, if it is pure inductive circuit, it will not consume any power. Right? Now, can you represent in phasor voltage and current? If you say this is voltage, where will be the current? 90 degrees behind. Like this. both will rotate with same angular velocity omega.
Any doubt, anything?
So, but in this case, power, panning it, when we take VR as it IRMS, why don't we get C? Why don't we take root VR?
See, VRMS into IRMS is incidental. It's not a formula that VRMS into IRMS should be power. It happens to be that when it is pure real resistance.
So, but in the case of an inductive circuit, that's what it is, right?
And one thing is this, that this inductive reactance can change with omega. That is something weird, because it's like changing resistance with frequency. Right? It's a function of frequency. You can change the resistance with frequency, and it makes sense. More is it omega means what? Rapidly the current is changing, or rapidly the voltage is changing. So inductor should resist it more. That is why its reactance is increasing. Now write down capacitor with AC. C with, okay, try to find out all of those things. So if charge is Q on it, the potential difference will be Q by C. So the loop rule will say V naught sine omega t minus Q by C is equal to 0. So I'll get Q equals to C V naught sin omega t. How much will be the current?
dq by dt.
Right? So current will be dq by dt. That will be equal to c times omega v naught sin omega t. This you can write it out
cos.
You can write this down as 1 by omega c cos of omega t. So 1 by omega c behaves like a resistance. This time it is capacitive reactance. 1 by omega c. Just to show that it's like a resistance.
You will write it in terms of sine also.
We are writing it. This is capacitive reactance. Okay. You can write this down in terms of sine as V naught by X C into sine of omega T plus pi by 2. So now you'll see that current is ahead of voltage by 90 degrees. Earlier, current was behind. Okay. So this is I and this is V. So we will have IRMS as V naught by root 2 times XC, VRMS as V naught by root 2. What is the average power? The power will be this current into voltage, right? Again, sine 2 omega t will come. Okay, average power will be 3 in 0. Fine. So if you draw the phase diagram, and if you say this is voltage, where will be the current? It will be ahead of voltage. This is current. Both of them rotating with omega. Fine. Any doubt? Yes. Okay. So these are the basic circuit elements. Or the basic circuits. Only resistance, only capacitor, only resistor, only the inductance. Now we will be combining them. Okay, but before we do that, let's solve few questions. No doubts on this, right? Write down. A pure inductor of inductance 25 millihenry. Inductance is 25 millihenry. It is connected to a source of voltage 220 volts. Find out inductive reactance XL and RMS value of current the frequency of source is 50 hertz. If I don't say anything, it means RMS. Every time in a question, if it is not mentioned what it is RMS. Right? Abhay, Abhay answer. Excel. What is the formula for Excel?
Omega L.
Omega L. How much is this? 2.5.
Exactly.
Omega is how much?
7.8.
Unit?
Omega is 7.8.
Not omega, XL.
Oh, it is empty. So,
it's ohms.
It's ohms.
Because V naught by that is current, right?
Yeah.
So, V naught by anything that is current means it has to be ohms. You got it?
7.8.
Omega is 7.5. Omega is 2 pi into frequency. This into L. This is 7.85 ohms. So frequency into 2 pi is omega. Don't directly use frequency as omega. What is IRMS?
IRMS.
This is a theoretical question. Tell me, a lamp is connected in a series with a capacitor. Suppose you have an inductor like this. Draw this. You have an inductor and there is a lamp that is connected like this. There is an AC supply. Okay. So lamp will glow. Okay. Now what you are doing is, you are putting an iron rod inside. Inside the coil, what will happen to the glow of the bulb? Increase, decrease, remain same?
You put it what inside?
Iron.
Wouldn't it increase? Iron is a good product.
Iron not touching anything.
What will happen to the glow of the bulb?
Bulb is glowing because of what? Why it is glowing? Because it is consuming power. I square R. What will happen to I square R? R will not change. So what will happen to current? If current increases, glow will increase. If current decreases, glow will decrease. What will happen to that? This is what is the problem. You are not... Why?
Because reactance will increase.
Reactance will increase?
So
the L value will increase or not?
Yes.
L will increase. So omega L will increase. And omega L increases, reactance increases, so current decreases. So glow will decrease. Next question. A 15 microfarad capacitor is connected to 220 volt 50 hertz supply. Find out capacitive reactance and the current RMS and the peak. These are like the basic questions so that you know you are able to. These are the questions which will help you to get familiar with the concept. Once you get familiar, then you have to solve those HC Verma and stuff. कितना है एक्स सी करना कैलकुलेट कौन करेगा उसको हु विल कैलकुलेट लाइक ओके आफ्टर राइटिंग इन
सर एक्स सी
222.2
212
या 212
हां तो आएगा जरा आंसर
1.0 इज आएगा 1.1
omega is what? 2 pi into f.
Yeah.
Into c, 15 into 10 is power minus 6.
Yeah.
You know, getting 2 to 12.
This is 10 raised to power 6 divided by 2 into 50 is 100. So this becomes 10 raised to power 4 divided by 15 pi. So it will be 100 divided by 15 into 100 divided by pi. So this is like 33 point something. And this is how much? 15. It's like 7. So 7 into 33.3. I mean, this is approximate, okay? 33 into 7. 7 is a 21. 21, 22. It's a rough calculation.
Yeah, it's like 212.
Answer is 212.
Yeah,
rough calculation
about
222.
212
is
about 220. Take it. What is IRMS? IRMS is nothing but 220 divided by XC.
That's 1 up.
220 divided by 212. This is rough. The exact value is 212. So it is 220 divided by 212. Okay. 1.08 कौन बोला?
Is I not 298
ऐसे ही? ये भी calculated? अरे guessing. Rough बहुत कर रहा है तू. Don't do anything like that. Answer is 1.04. And peak current is how much? Peak current is root 2 times of this. Which is 1.47. Now tell me what will happen if you increase the frequency. If you double the frequency, what all things will change?
XC
will become how, what? If it is right now 212, what will become if you make omega 2 omega?
XC
will be 212 divided by 2.
Yes, 106.
Right? And current will double.
Yeah, double.
Fine. Just by changing frequency, you are able to increase the current. Right? But then at our home, there is a fixed frequency of current that is coming in. That is 50 Hertz. So you don't usually change the frequency.